Let me tell you about Kitu, a fourth grader in an orphanage in Kenya. He's a great kid, just like you. He loves reading and has a vivid imagination. His best friend is named Ngozi. He is a hard-working student, and his favorite food is pilau. Our story really starts in chapter 2, when 3 shocking things happen to Kitu. So he's in the library one day, and then he sees this box of books. Mrs. Kiafa, that's the librarian's name. Mrs. Kiafa says she's getting rid of those books because they're too damaged to be on the shelves. Don't librarians want books in their libraries? That's shock number 1. Okay, then Mrs. Kiafa says he can look in the box and keep 1 or 2 books. Kitu can't believe that she's gonna let him keep and take one, you know, because he's used to checking them out and bringing them back to the library. That's just what you do. So that is shock number 2. Okay, so now he's looking through the box and he sees that, yeah, some of these books are in really bad condition. However, he does see one book that looks promising. It's called Sports Around the World. And this is when you see something completely unexpected. There's a picture of athletes wearing heavy-looking clothing and big boots with metal blades on them, and they're standing on this weird kind of white surface. Remember how I said that Kitu lives in Kenya? Kenya is in Africa. It's close to Ethiopia and Somalia. And the weather in Kenya is hot. It doesn't snow there. Anyway, Mrs. Kiafa tells Kitu that these athletes are ice hockey players in Canada, and the ice is frozen water. Kitu has never seen ice hockey, and he's never seen ice before. So that is shock number 3. So Kitu decides he wants to learn how to skate and one day play ice hockey. So if you like stories about kids trying hard to make their dreams come true, and if you were wondering what happens to Kitu, well, you absolutely have to read this book, Hockey Night in Kenya by Danson, Mutinda, and Eric Walters.